I'm going to give you proof from the laws of physics, the Big Bang, and theory of evolution are impossible, and I'm going to do it in less than 10 minutes. The law of conservation of angular momentum causes very serious problems for the Big Bang theory and the theory of evolution. One way to understand the law of conservation of angular momentum is to illustrate this law of physics with a practical everyday life example. For example, let's think about a merry-go-round in a park. Let's imagine that we have some children playing on a merry-go-round in a park. We ask the children to sit on the merry-go-round and hold tight, and then we begin to spin the merry-go-round. As we push, let's say it is now traveling at about 15 miles per hour and the children are enjoying the ride. As we begin to push faster, the merry-go-round speeds up to, say, let's say 30 miles per hour. And it becomes harder for the children to hang on, and some of them are beginning to become a little frightened, and they cry out, "Stop, stop, please slow down." But continuing with our experiment, we push even faster, and the merry-go-round spins much faster, even up to speeds, let's say, as high as 40 to 45 miles per hour. At this speed, the gravitational and centrifugal forces on the children sitting on the merry-go-round are making it so that they can no longer hold on, and they all fly off the merry-go-round. With our simple experiment complete, we can now come to a conclusion. Because of the law of conservation of linear momentum and the law of centrifugal force, the children were not able to hold on and flew off of the merry-go-round. When that happened, the laws of physics and momentum demand that they should fly off the merry-go-round, moving in the same direction as the merry-go-round was spinning. If it was rotating clockwise, the children will also be thrown off in a clockwise direction. Now let's apply the law of conservation of angular momentum to the Big Bang theory. In the case of the Big Bang theory, the point of singularity, or the very hot, dense point of origin, was supposed to have spun very fast and then exploded in a frictionless vacuum environment, which is the condition the Big Bang theory tells us the universe was in when the Big Bang occurred. According to the law of conservation of angular momentum, all the matter, the planets, galaxies, constellations, and every other object in the universe should spin in the same direction as the original point of singularity was spinning. We know from scientific observation of the planets, just in our own solar system alone, that the planets Venus, Uranus, and possibly Pluto spin in the opposite direction to the other six planets. In addition to that, there are 63 known moons of the planets, and of these moons, six spin in the opposite direction to the remaining 57. According to the law of conservation of angular momentum, that is impossible. In our solar system, three of the planets, Jupiter, Saturn, and Neptune, have moons orbiting in both directions. And these previously stated facts are quoted from the Astronomical Almanac for the year 1989 from Washington, D.C., U.S. Government Printing Office, page E88. From the law of conservation of angular momentum, we can see that if our solar system evolved spontaneously from a big bang, all the moons should orbit their planets in the same direction. The only exception to this would be as if they encountered a large mass, such as another planet, with enough force to cause the angular momentum to completely stop spinning and then begin spinning in the reverse direction. But we have no evidence of that anywhere. And what would that force be? Anything powerful enough to stop a moon or planet from spinning and to cause it to start spinning again in the opposite direction would certainly be strong enough to rip the planet or moon apart in the process. However, even if it were possible, and it did actually occur many times over, these events should certainly have left some evidence, something such as a large crater on each planet or moon affected, which would be able to be observed by astronomers. But then how does science explain that we have entire galaxies spinning in different directions? What would be powerful enough to change the momentum of multiple entire galaxies and not leave any evidence at all. Current scientific observations of the universe and the laws of physics do not and cannot support the Big Bang theory. And without the Big Bang theory, the theory of evolution of species is groundless and actually absurd. Let's examine the difference of angular momentum of the Sun and the planets. The Sun actually spins much more slowly than the planets. This certainly does not support the Big Bang theory, as explained in the following quotation from Dr. H. Reeves in the book The Origin of the Solar System, page 9, printed by the John Wiley and Sons of New York in 1978. Quote, "This angular momentum would have caused the Sun to spin very rapidly. Actually, our Sun spins very slowly while the planets move very rapidly around the Sun. In fact, although the Sun has over 99% of the mass of the solar system, it has only 2% of the angular momentum. This pattern is directly opposite to the pattern predicted for the nebular hypothesis." Unquote. Neither scientists nor evolutionists can explain the observed conditions of the law of angular momentum in the universe or even in our own solar system. Quoting from Dr. Stuart Ross Taylor, a solar system evolutionist and scientist, in the book Solar System Evolution, A New Perspective, page 53, printed by Cambridge University Press in 1992, Dr. Ross Taylor states the following, quote, "The ultimate origin of the solar system's angular momentum remains obscure," unquote. That's scientific and evolutionist language for, "We can't explain it, but we're not going to change our ideas because we are so biased in our thinking that we absolutely refuse to entertain the possibility of the existence of a master designer, God, because doing so would mean that we may be held responsible for our actions someday." Now let's examine one more piece of evidence in the Milky Way galaxy itself. If the Big Bang theory were true, in addition to all the galaxies and planets all spinning in the same direction, all matter in the universe would need to be evenly distributed, including even distribution throughout our own solar system. But that is not what we see. Throughout the Milky Way galaxy alone, there are enormous clusters of stars, and then great areas of empty space. Please explain how this would come about if all matter were evenly distributed in all directions by the Big Bang. Scientists and evolutionists have no answer. Thank you.